side of ECS, our final map of today, and it will be cobble between Optic and, of course, TSM.
Yeah, and we already saw an amazing first map. It was incredibly close, but ultimately, Optic just pulled out ahead.
The first or second half was split right down the middle.
Yeah.
It was literally one streak of rounds, and Optic won all of the rest to close out the map.
Yeah. We have seen some amazing individual performances from both TSM and Optic, and well, I think we have a number of key players to kind of keep an eye on as we head into tonight's matchup on Cobblestone.
Not the most expected ones, though, in a lot of it. Like, I feel like NAF was one that we didn't really mention too much, and with the AWP, maybe not so much in the first half, but in the second on the CT side, he was pivotal for their play. Mixwell actually wasn't really on the map until right near the end where he started to step up, and that was when they were actually playing some of their better rounds. But at the same time, he definitely wasn't highlighted. And in terms of Stan as well on the B side, he was really good as well.
Yeah, no, definitely. I think Stan is someone that we didn't really speak about much at all, and I would say he was one of the most reliable players within that matchup just then. I mean, consistently holding down the B site. At the end, we saw him finish it on what, like a 3
Triple
or a 4K
K,
to lock the game out in favor of Optic.
Yeah.
So yeah, no, it was an incredible game. And as we head into this now, I mean, a player who does spring to mind, I suppose, for the opposing team over on TSM to keep our eye on. Who would you say it would be?
I still, even though he wasn't.
Are you going to say
Semphis? No, I'm still going to go with Sick.
Oh, okay, Sick.
I have
Sick,
to
fair
every
enough.
Single time. Like Semphis, for me, he had a good first half on that CT side, but a CT side AWPer on Dust 2, it seems to be much easier at the moment, especially depending where you're playing. We saw it from NAF as well. Both players actually had a very good CT side, but the AWP on this map, I feel like it needs to be a little bit more aggressive, and I don't think that works too well with Semphis' style of play. Yes, you can play it sort of over towards Statue, maybe, as a defensive AWP, maybe if he wants to go solo on A, but I'm not sure I want him to be solo on A. I think that's a pretty hefty task, even for an AWPer, and even when it's like Kenny, you sometimes need a little bit of support, so putting it solely on Semphis would be heavy. But yeah, Sick, I think around sort of drop-down position, he can be very pivotal in actually holding down a lot of the site. But yeah, so far, it's been a sort of spread across the board. I don't think there's been any hugely standing out players. I think Relics as well, standing in with the sort of aggressive entry frags will be important. He did very well doing that yesterday, even though they lost versus Cloud9. I think a lot of the picks they found on Mirage, sometimes it was him getting a 2 or 3K. And on Cobble, well, we saw that today. That can be so impressive. Like,
yeah.
I think Apex was just phenomenal on Cobblestone.
Yeah, no, definitely. Something as well I feel like we should draw on. Whenever you go for the really extended bit of analysis, whenever you're doing the casting, and I do always feel like this is a genuinely awkward thing that everyone has to come across, right? You're probably going to agree with me. The awkward stare into each other's eyes, right?
Yeah, no.
I feel like we're... what is it? They don't really do it in the UK, but in America, you know, like whenever you're in like stadiums, they get the camera
Kiss
to go
cam.
On. Yeah, that's the one. I feel like that's what we're on. I assure you, face it, that's not what we're about.
No, that's not going to happen. I think you're taken as well. I don't think your girlfriend would be
too
happy.
Yeah, no, she wouldn't.
That.
She would be extremely angry. probably rip what little hair does remain on your head off.
Please,
so yeah, no.
I'm clinging on to dear life already.
I don't want
to lose
good.
That.
But yeah, no, so we should be getting in any minute now.
Yeah.
But
do you want me to just stare deeply into the camera instead?
Or one player that I would be keen on seeing some more from would be Mixwell. I thought that he was incredibly quiet in that matchup. Not kind of any of us were expecting. Everyone kind of referenced him as someone
who's... do with Optic.
Yeah, no,
do.
Exactly. He's someone who is a major talking point behind the Optic roster. And he actually came in, I believe, what, last second to last or something?
Yeah, he wasn't
so
having the sort of crazy impact he was having. And towards the end, yes, he was able to hold it off relatively well. But even in some of the later rounds, like, for example, you take that sort of double kill from NAF. The only reason I had to come in is because Mixo was dominated over towards long, and everybody came rushing through, and he had to sort of get a little bit lucky with the lineup of three players just crossing paths all at once. You don't cross the streams. I've learned that from Ghostbusters. And it almost lined up. It was like the perfect moment, but didn't quite get the third. But that's the sort of point. If they weren't losing long, none of that would have ever happened.
Yeah, no, exactly. And I think as we come into Cobble, some of those issues that we saw kind of presenting themselves within the lineup of Optic, despite them taking the victory, do you think they might start to kind of shine through a little bit more here, as Cobble is undisputedly so a more team-based map? But then at the same time, it did feel like it was more individual performances messing up for them. The team as a whole did seem to be quite well synergized.
I don't know. I think you could sort of say that for both, because a lot of it came down, like, what TSM were doing towards the end, it wasn't like the team play was bad. It was just like finding the entry kills, losing a couple of silly plays, and maybe the trades as well, to like the very last round where they're running in towards Stan and he's just able to pick them off one by one. But like, they weren't missing smokes. They weren't doing any strategies that I thought, oh, that's just plain stupid. It was more just they were losing the picks and getting a little bit unlucky in some of the circumstances. So to almost say oh, yeah, no, they're not synergizing as a team. I don't think that's ever going to be the case.
That's fair enough.
But I do kind of get your point, and especially just with the players that are stepping up, because a lot of the time, say you do have a player who normally steps up massive like Mixwell or Tarek or something like that, if you then have the other players going off as well, like say that you add what you just had from Optic and you add Mixwell, GG. There's nothing that can be done. Yes, sick. And, well, Twist is another one. I think in the pistol rounds, he was very impactful, like coming in with the deegs. And there was a round or two where he actually clutched out. But in the actual rifle rounds, I don't really remember saying his name at all.
Yeah, I know. He was extremely absent. The only time I remember talking about him was just, Mixwell's playing over towards Long. Oh, Mixwell's died over towards Long. No, that was kind of the impact he was having. But, you know, everyone else was kind of there to pick up the pieces. It was very nice to see. Then you look at the side of TSM. Someone for me who did kind of fall off a little bit towards the end is definitely Senfis.
Oh, no, he went absent completely.
Yeah, he needs to be the one to kind of chime in with the counter-op against the combination that we saw in the form of Tarek and Naf.
It was mainly Naf, but when they got the money, that double-op setup, I think that actually changed the game.
Oh, yes,
because
100%.
You sort of look to when they started winning that streak, and you go, do you know what? The double orb really did play that sort of pivotal role. It opened up the rounds a lot easier and made things just a little bit more dynamic in the way they were actually playing. So I definitely do think that double orb was viable. In terms of the way it can be used on Cobble, there is potential for it, but I feel like a lot of teams sometimes over-dedicate themselves to double orbs. I think Na'Vi are actually team regionally. You look at their form on Cobble at the moment, it is horrific. I think they've lost some ridiculously bad results on Cobble, and a lot of it is because they go, okay, things aren't working, double orb set up every time. And they would just be like, okay, simple, you're picking up that secondary orb, Guardian. And it just doesn't work. Sometimes you need to know when to do it, when to not. On Dust2 there, that was definitely a point to do it. And I feel like on Dust2 in general, it is a much more viable strategy. On Cobble, sometimes it works. For some teams, it works. I think VP do it quite well, and Pasha or Neo, whoever's sort of in that position, picks it up as well as Snacks. That's a nice sort of spot. So maybe there's an opportunity for them to pick it up, but I would say they shouldn't be going into it thinking like that. I think it's probably a better idea to just have the sort of ball on Nap or whoever's actually taking it, because, of course, they have sort of switched it around a little bit. As you said, maybe Mixwell doesn't want to be picking up so much, which I do think would be a shame because he is very, very talented with it.
Yeah, no, I mean, definitely so. The other thing you have to take into account is it did seem like, I wouldn't say there was any clear preference between either side as to their whether or not they preferred the T or CT side over on Dust2, but that's because I do feel it's one of the more like free-flowing maps, can dominate on either side. Now, Cobblestone, I do feel, is one that lends itself more towards either side, depending on what team's kind of on it. You would say it's ever so slightly more T-sided in recent updates, definitely.
I think, in the olden days, back originally, when the map was horribly designed and there was a big hole in the wall where you could go and sit in the toilets behind the B site. Then it was CT-sided because the map literally made no sense. Now, they've tried to add in different avenues for the CT side. I think the stairs have actually been quite impactful in actually bringing it back a little bit, because you could see teams like Na'Vi where they would get four round CT side, still win comfortably on the T side. And that was not, I think in that form, yes, I do kind of like maps where it's not just balanced, because although Valve wants every map to be sort of balanced, I quite like having CT and T sided maps. Like they're changing a round of nuke. I always thought, okay, I don't know if that's really the problem, because the point was you were supposed to have to grind out rounds. So I don't know about that, but I think the stairs definitely made it a little bit more interesting, because rather than having to boost players up there, it's nades as well that sort of change things a little bit, and it gives an opportunity for information, which has always been a problem with Cobble.
Enough talk about stairs. Let's go ahead.
I do too,
but I'm sure everyone's getting a little tired about the talk of stairs sitting me and you, and I'm sure they want to be seeing some great gameplay between Optic and TSM. So
I'd hope sure so. If they were here just for us, I would have a slight problem with that. I don't think that's it.
We're going to be going ahead and hopping in any second now. I've just been informed that we are going to be starting.
Here we go.
That was a bit of a timing gobble for me.
Almost looked planned.
Yeah, no, exactly. But here we go. And I'm going to be donning my best Rick Astley impersonation throughout this whole thing. For any of you wondering, I just remembered that's something that I'm never going to give you up. Yeah, I'm never going to give
up. But don't worry, he'll never let you down either.
Yeah, never going to run around.
Okay, we're stopping there.
It is going to be just once again full armor across the board on the side of Optic. They've been religiously kind of doing this, not opting for the defuse kit, just going all five players with armor. It's fairly interesting. It does allow them to have a little bit more kind of availability in their movement. They don't have someone who's kind of going to be getting aim punched to the ceiling. At the same time, though, they can't really afford to let that bomb go down.
Yeah, they have to play a very sort of specific style to actually stop this from going down. And in terms of the T side, well, they're going to go very aggressive out long. Now, the positions actually coming out from the CT side could make this wonderful for them. They have the flank already in play. They've got two players rotating in. You look at the position from Relics, is pretty much useless because there's nobody actually that far around. Mixor will catch off Semphis as well, and it seems like all the positions have just worked wonderfully for Optic. It leaves just FNS and Sick. FNS will be tapping away. He's been pretty good with the pistol so far, and he's adding to it again. Gretz too, but unfortunately, it's not quite enough for that pistol round at least. As said, the positions work out, and really, they were just a little bit unlucky. The setup was very, very good from Optic.
Yeah, no, that was looking very good there from them right from the outset. You get two on Mixwell very early on. Stanisaurus chiming in one of his own. They do both get taken down sadly, but then it's now Fly to close things out at the end. And then they get the defuse as well. They pissed around. It's going to be going the way of Optic very early on. And that's exactly what we like to see. I mean, a strong start. Start as you mean to go on. Of course, this is their map choice. So it would be a bit of a shame if they don't, you know, pick up the pistol at least. As we continue into this, though, it's going to be anti-eco for the Optic side. We've got three rifles and two umps to try and build up some money.
Yeah, of course, the farming can come in. Looking like a save will come out for the TSM side of thing, looking for that next round purchase. Stan is going to go looking, and this is a great opportunity to farm up some cash. Now, they do know this is coming. They've got three rifles on the board already on the CT side, so not too many problems there. Stan already going to make $1,200, goes rotating back around. FNS should know his position and actually catches him off guard, so at least something found in this round. He will, in fact, get himself an SMG, and before he can even do anything with it, it will be enough to finish him off.
Yeah, lots of money farmed up there on the back of the umps. As Netfly managed to grab himself a nice tiny bit of money. He's on $4,600 currently. Mixwell as well finds some frags on the back of his. Now he's going to be upgrading it as he does manage to grab the M4. So we're going to be seeing a good bit of investment here kind of across the board. And Netfly sticking with the UMP, but TSM, they have bought up because they did get the bomb plant in that initial round. So they're going to have the AKs across the board. Good bit of utility to try and work with into this round. So it looks like they're going to be working their way in towards B. Every single member of TSM here, they have Twist to watch the flank. And it looks like he could potentially find Stanisaurus. He's gone quite aggressive. Starts to push out of A. Gotta get some information here. Sick, they're gonna be the first man out onto the site. Very aggressive. Not gonna be waiting at all for that smoke to fade. They make their way out. FNS gonna find that first frag. Rush over by Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Not gonna be peeking out just yet. Danger of being caught out. It's actually Tarrant gonna be the first. Oh, FNS looking for a dirty, but as he picks that up, just completely cleaning TSM. Completely cleaning Optic out of the site. Sorry. And yeah, I mean, that was insane on behalf of FNS. He completely won the site over for TSM. And, I mean, there was so little work needed to be done by the rest of the team by the end of that.
Yeah, no, massive entry kills coming in all the way across the shop. There were plenty of players here when the push came in, and it almost looked really problematic for a TSM going into the site. You think, okay, there's four, maybe even a fifth player coming in on the flank, and that's, you're like, okay, there's no way. And then FNS just goes, nope, don't worry, guys. I've got this in the bag. Finishes off pretty much every single player, leaving just one. Now the buy will come back up. It's an AWP onto NAF, which can at least be some sort of pivotal role for them. This can be the catalyst that brings them forward, and when it would already end the life of Semphis.
Yeah, but Semphis going down early on does, of course, mean that a major player on the side of TSM is going to be removed from the equation. The man in fight is now leaning in the way of Optic, and while Sick looking to rock out with his Glock out, trying to run away from the long area. In danger of Tarek potentially being able to pick one up on the back of the UMP, is just going to be falling on back. So they do manage to grab control of the long platform slightly. There is still Sick there to try and watch out for. But meanwhile, TSM making their way through mid. Mixwell playing up close with the Mag 7. It's going to be the only silver lining here. Might be able to land a couple of frags on the back of that. $800 kill bonus as well. Isn't too shabby. And it is going to be devastatingly effective at this range.
Almost touching through the wall. Relics will go pushing and going to try and find an opening back into this round. It does look like they're about to hit this A site. And in terms of the rotation, it's going to be Sick, but it's the Mag 7 that starts things off. Mixwell, he's going to look for the dunk at the end, and FNS is gone. Kobe Bryant would be proud of that one. Rush, well, he will actually kill Tarek in the meantime. Not happy with his performance in that round, clearly, and decides to finish him off for the T side. Other than that, not really anything lost. I just love how perfect this nade was in landing onto FNS. Literally just bounces right in off two walls, and it's just like, hello.
Yeah, no, that was nice. And I like the fact you gave it its own little voice. It's
The Nates don't mean to be.
It's not a family show. It's a kids show now. we're bringing the age group down day by day. But there we go. Optic, they pick up a third round on the board. And, well, TSM, they've only managed to get one so far. This round, they're going to be on the back foot once again. Force buying up. You've got the the Galil up on Twists.
Close.
Yeah, nearly got that. And two Tech-9s on the back of Sempfis and Relics and a few P250s on the remaining members of the T side. They'll be trying to find what they can. As it looks like they'll be making their way towards B. Relics the one to try and open things up, potentially in through drop. Meanwhile, Sempfis and the rest of the gang make their way out onto Plat.
Now who's making it sound like a kid show?
Me,
Sempfis and the gang are going to be coming and pushing out. Let's go, Sempfis. And well, he's not going anywhere other than to the grave. It will be Taric to finish things off. Well, at the moment, there's four players ready to try and push back in. Taric is not really being pushed at the moment. He's unable to just peek back towards drop, and he's finishing everything off for now. Still waiting for the plat spot to come in, but it's actually Rush just holding this down. Eventually, FNS will find the one frag of the round, but other than that, it's going to be nothing else. Nice hold from Taric, and well, that will be it. Just pistols coming in for TSM in this round. They will get a couple of rounds loss bonus in the next, but not anything to really idle at.
Yeah, I do think a better choice might have been, you know, just to have, on the previous round, you know, bite the bullet on the side of TSM, let yourself, you know, be in that situation where you do forego the round. I mean, they wanted to try and potentially make their way back into it with the limited buys they had. This round, it's all going to be mixed well in mid. He finds three through the smoke. It's going to get taken out by Sick, and then Stannis ought to finish it off. That's a complete and utter mop-up. And once again, for the second time in a row, we are going to have four players surviving on the side of Optic. So the money situation is going to be looking fantastic. Can't give Mixwell too much credit. It was for a smoke, which is pretty interesting. But they were, you know, just poor, naked, unarmored kind of TSM members.
So basically, you're saying he's slaughtering the weak.
Yeah, which is pretty horrific. So you know, you can't be giving him too much gratitude for that situation. I mean, that's going to be a full buy on the cards for TSM. They're looking to take mid control once again. Mixwell, this time here to answer back with an AWP in hand.
And this is what we wanted to see. I'm almost a little bit excited, like a kid at Christmas, waiting to see if Mixwell can find these picks. Of course, on the other side of things, they have got the AKs on the board. Still no AWP yet in play. And well, here goes Mixwell. First pick will be found. Looking for more. Grabs a second at least. And now Stanislav will be pushing back in to find one, not quite the second, so it is still an opportunity at least. Sick will pick up the AWPs, low on health, and well, it seems like the right decision to make. The problem is FNS is actually going to be rotating away, and well, he's caught by Naf, pushes straight into his hands and leaves Sick to try and play versus three.
Yeah, goes to pick out onto Taric, but Taric is there with the M4 at close range. Managed to take him down as well. So now it's going to go 6-1 Optic. Looking to be incredibly strong. Five rounds the difference between them and TSM currently, as they are pulling ahead very much so. A very healthy economy as well, starting to build up. $9,000 on Nafly, $8,600 on the back of Stanislaw. And TSM once again relegated onto the back foot. They're going to be in a bit of a force, buying up on Sick, Relics, and Twists. Everyone else just having a few pistols here and there. And FNS with a Deagle, looking to try and break some heads.
Yeah, we do look towards just these pistols once again. Not really expecting anything too crazy, but it has been known to happen on Cobble. Smoke does have a little bit of a gap in it, and a Molotov will be thrown into the smoke, which of course has no effect at all. FNS is going to be peeking around and isn't able to find anything just yet. And Rush will go for a little bit of a span through the smoke. Really, we're looking towards Stan. He's the one up close, ready and waiting to try and hold off drop. He's actually looking in the wrong direction and could get pinted here. Needs some support, but actually he'll spray down too. Not going to be anything coming in. Naf will finish off one more twist. He does finally find Stan, but, well, actually just going to have to switch out. Can't get the kill onto Taric either, and this is starting to get a little bit ridiculous for Optic. The money is through the roof. The rounds are getting through the roof. And, well, TSM, they're about to get themselves into a bit of a detrimental position. The scary thing as well is Twist and Relics, and Sempfis, in fact, are with three kills or two kills between them. That might help them out a little bit, though.
Nah, it's just a bit of a handicap. You know, Taric helping out the side of TSM there. Does Knife rush down to 39 HP straight off the bat. Not sure what the grand idea was behind that. Sempfis, welcome to the scoreboard. Finally picks up a frag, better late than never. We are in round number 9. Don't be too embarrassed. Plenty of time for you to find some more throughout the game, I'm sure. Nafly going to be able to get one back on a sick. They put it into a 4-on-4. Now, though, TSM trying to test the waters out towards long. They can manage to find a frag here already. Back of Sempfis, now he's going to be peeking out, looking to try and find one in the Stanislaw as well, who is ready and waiting towards long for any potential members of TSM that might just be wandering into his crosshairs.
Last emphasis holding, and he will actually get the peek as well. Stan is taken out of the round, and this does give them an opportunity to go over towards the A site. The rotation seemingly coming in from the bomb, and the CTs may just opt to do the same. They've got Rush rotating in. Of course, he's very low on HP because of the mistake made at the beginning of the round, and well, now they're going to have players pushing in. Rush will actually manage to find one, so it's back to a 3v3, and Tarik in a little bit of an off angle. Can he find anything? Quiz going to get close. He's raised down one, looks for the second. Relics, well, he's going to lose his life as well, and it's Tarik going big, leaving just FNS. He's managed to sneak towards the site, doesn't have the bomb, has a little bit of time, but the second he shoots, that should be the exact position known. Peeking all at once, and will Rush, even though he's taken down, even though he's given the handicap, he still finds two kills.
Yeah, it's going to go 8-1, and Optic, they have a 7-round advantage over TSM. It's looking incredibly strong here, and I mean, there's just no, they're just not showing any signs of stopping right now. I mean, TSM, they're having some real problems trying to remedy this. It doesn't help that you have, what, three players who up until now are all on one frag apiece or less? So, you know, it is less than ideal, to say the least. Once again, TSM on the back foot are going to be having to buy down what they can. A little bit of armor up on Twists, FNS, and Sick. Everyone else opting for the Tech-9s. A little bit of utility as well. And a Deagle up on Senphis. Stannis, although waiting in that smoke, everyone just walks on past him. He's let them go just, you know, right in from behind. But Senphis is going to be there just, you know, chilling out, relaxing all cool and shooting some B-ball outside of the school. And, well, Sick there to get the trade frag back. Puts it into a 4-on-4. Currently, though, TSM looking a little bit confused as to what just happened there. Stannis is going to be down in mid. They do get the M4 in the back of it, and that's going to be up on Sick. He does have armor to work with as well. And now they're going to be making their way in towards this B site. Nafly over towards Plat, along with Tarik, the two players tasked with trying to hold back this push.
Yeah, Sick and Co will be coming in from drop down. Now, in terms of the positioning, really, we have to look towards Tarik. He's holding up close, and if he can catch them out, there could be problems. There's 50 seconds left on the clock. They don't have to dedicate towards B, but just the positioning suggests that they will. In fact, start jumping the other way, and Sick will catch out Tarik. He goes aggressive, and Rush is caught as well. Mix were able to trade one, but that's the A site fallen. And Naf is the last one remaining. Doesn't really have too much of a chance of getting back into this one, especially now that they've picked up a couple of rifles as well, and surprisingly out of all the rounds that they could possibly win, it's looking like TSM are going to try and grab this one. Either way, Naf, well, he's got the dualies. As I said, not a weapon we see too often. You said it's the best pistol in the game, so I'm going to take your word for it, and well, now we see if he can challenge with it.
Yeah, making his way up long. Sick is going to be ready and waiting on the other side of this smoke. The interesting thing is Nafly is pretty dedicated to try and make something happen here. Just going to be edging his way through, trying to wait for the smoke to fade. And as he makes his way through, he's actually going to be walking straight past Sick. Not going to be able to spot it out just yet. Just keeps on going onto the site. Oh, it was looking so good. But then you realize Sick isn't a Silver 3 and isn't about to let that happen. So he's going to take him down with the tech and grab the AWP for the side of TSM. Finally, they get their second round on the board. And well, now there's only 6 rounds between them and Optic.
Yeah, and the big thing is this is the step-up round from Sick. He finally comes onto the map, he finally wakes up, and he gets a 4K for his troubles. So much better stuff from him individually. Now we need to see the rest of the team step up behind him, otherwise they'll be straight back on that reset. Of course, Optic, we've already spoken about their economy. It's still pretty ridiculous. They're going to have enough money to get a fully-fledged buy on the board. Naf will even purchase up the Julies behind his AWP.
Yeah, he's been a huge fan of them, what can I say? You know, and rightfully so. I mean, you know, he hasn't had the chance to use them yet, but I'm sure when he does, it's going to be a spectacle indeed. 8-2 currently, though, in TSM. They've been able to get 4 rifles on the cards for the first time in quite a while, and the AWP up on Senphis. This is the best case scenario we've seen them in quite some time. Senphis trying to spot out a player as he covers his team as they push through into mid. They do grab control of it relatively easily. Meanwhile, in towards that B site, no aggression coming out from Optics. They have very little information as to where TSM are. So when they do finally execute out onto this A site, the rotate isn't going to have a lot of time to get there, providing that, you know, they can drop the two players on this A site. Well, as it all falls on the Stannisaw up here in the boost, the best he can really hope for is a one and done. He gets it. Isn't going to get traded out just yet, but he buys no time for the rotation. TSM can just grab the site off the bat. Senphis finds one on a rush as well. And now it's a one-man advantage leaning the way of TSM.
Yeah, and they are trying to get rid of Stan. He's going to be a pain in their side if they can't, and there's Relics to do just that. The bomb will be planted, and without the flank in play anymore, the value of the CT's positions has just gone down to a big, fat zero. So they will fall back, not going to try and challenge this round. You can see there's still 8K and 7,500 onto Rush and Naf, so maybe not too much of a problem with them getting a buy on the ball, but they want to make sure that they do, so keeping the rifles in play is definitely a good idea.
Yeah, definitely. So, I mean, Nafly's been able to get $7,500, which, of course, does allow him to drop to his team. If they keep these rifles and the AWP as well, it just lowers the cost of the next round. They should be able to buy up regardless. But, I mean, think about it. This is going to take, what, something like $10,000 almost. Well, $13,700, actually. I just remembered you could look up at the top. And, you know, out of them having to spend, which is an incredible amount of money. So it will make this next round buy very feasible. They're going to be able to get lots of utility across the board. And maybe you'd have some money left to pay for me to get a haircut, so who knows?
Or a wig.
Oh, what, for you? I was going to say,
yeah,
what,
no,
why
don't
would I need a wig?
You need a wig.
No, I don't. Know. I got enough to make my own. But yeah,
maybe I could do like a Wayne Rooney hair transplant. I have been thinking about that. Does anybody know Wayne's barber? Either way, CT side, they are going to get themselves that buy back on the board. They have the AWP in hand onto Naf, which was saved from the previous round. Tarik going to utilize the boost position. Finally, TSM starting to string a few rounds in a row. Maybe they can continue this, of course, a long way back from the position they've got themselves into. The T side is normally favored, but you never know. Maybe they're going to be the ones to change our minds on that factor in the next half. But they've got to give themselves a chance. And Naf, well, he doesn't like that idea already. Trying to spam away some shots. It will be a tag from Sempus, but not the kill. And Naf will survive. Tarik still remaining in the smoke. He's on just one HP. Mixwell has in the meantime come into support, but it's still just going to be even trade. Somehow Naf still survives. FNS as well. He's on two HP, so not really doing too much better at this point. A minute left on the clock, and we're waiting for the T's to make their move.
Oh, we'll look at the boost from Stanislaus. This is going to be so good as he makes his way up towards the tree. Going to be able to help out, find Mixwell on one. And then they combine to find the three frags at the end. Stanislaus gets one, Mixwell finds two, and it's going to be the ninth round on the board for Optic. It was looking good for TSM as they made their way out, but it gets shut down. Sadly, I mean, Stanislaus, I was hoping he was going to have a little bit more impact into that, hoping it was going to be, you know, the little 3K of dreams.
He gets the one with two HP.
Mixwell comes through and actually does the brunt of the work, but regardless, it's going to be 9-3, six rounds ahead currently, and they're going to be in a great situation economically as well. TSM have more than enough money to buy up into this round, at least the four rifles on the board with the AWP up on Sempest yet again. Something that would be great to see start to work out for them a little bit more. Mixwell going to find the first one of Relics, and you can already see TSM to try and play off the back of this. They lose the player early on, now they're just committing in towards this B site.
Again, Mixwell definitely looking revitalized for this map. And, well, this is sort of the scary prospect we mentioned before. If Mixwell added to the already prominent side of things, of course, we're watching Stan. He's coming in from behind, just flanking all the way around. There's no lurker, of course, so this makes things so much more difficult at this point in time. And here he goes, the peak. He will snap onto the head of Twist and take him out.
Still here, going to be able to chime in, picks up two frags. Sempfis, going to be there for the return. It's going to be a one versus two. Nafly and Mixwell, the two players left, trying to hunt down Sempfis in this situation. That's a terrifying prospect, because these are two big names we were talking about. And as Sempfis tries to make his way in towards the A site, he's going to be isolated and alone. Sadly, no one else from his team able to trade from him, as they are all 6 feet under. Sempfis, though, is going to be reading this well, as no one's here for the side of Optic. Mixwell, so you're looking a little bit curious, trying to rotate on in from that B side. Sempfis able to find him, does good damage, but he's going to get tagged down low. Not able to find anything there on a Mixwell. 73 HP on both of these players, and about 7 on the side of Sempfis.
Yeah, he is going to get a bomb plant, so that's something valuable for his team, at least a little bit of extra money going into the next round of Lost Bonus City. Of course, he does have the AWP, so maybe finding a one pick could give him an opportunity to fight the round back, but Naf is a little bit quicker, and with so many angles to check, Sempfis is unable to win the round. So it is going to be... Oh, that's not a very happy face. I don't feel like that's the best one for the clutch. We need Skadoodle back with Welcome to the Clutch.
Yeah, no, I mean, it would be good indeed. But yeah, I mean, you know, we can get that really depressing, sad face up in here. Just set the mood for the rest of everything.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Yeah, I hope everyone enjoyed that. God, it's become all too real. But yeah, it's going to be 10-3. And as the crippling depression and reality of our existential crisis sets in, we're going to be heading into the 14th round. 10-3, currently 7 rounds, the difference between these two teams. And, well, rifles on rifles once again. 4 AKs for the side of TSM, and an AWP up on Sempfis, but then to try and make this one work. Optic actually, you know, struggling a little bit lately. They did pick up that last round, though, and TSM have actually been having a good impact on what we've seen. So these last few rounds have been the closest so far. The question is, it's all good being close, but TSM need to be converting these into round wins sooner rather than later.
Yeah, they do need to get themselves, well, pretty much the rest. I don't think that's really an argument at this point. They're looking at a best-case scenario of 5 rounds on the T side. That's not anywhere near enough. Stan is going to throw in the boost, which Well, I don't think they've utilized just yet, so already really dynamic with their play. I think that's something that we really have to give props for at the moment for Optic. They've switched up a lot of their CT setups, and they've been caught out so many times, the TSM side. So now, will they be caught out by Stan? That's the big question. As said, they haven't really used this yet. The wood will give Sick a little bit of a standpoint to defend from, but he's going to be spotted out. Now it's whether or not Stan fights at the right time. He's going to find one, but that's going to be the quick trade. Mixwell over towards the ramp is going to be able to trade one back, and that does give a good opportunity in the 3v3 with the surrounding of the T's. They have to fire out from all directions, and already it will be a quick trade, the loss of one of each.
Sempest in from long was going to be the player who could have potentially held this back, but as he falls, it's going to be increasingly hard here for Twist to try and close this one out. Rush finds him through the pole, takes him down in Optic. They pick up an 11th on the board. Once again, an incredibly close round, but ultimately Optic come out on top. And TSM, they really need to try and do something sooner rather than late. I mean, we can see right now, Optic have won an incredible amount in a row. They're going to be on another three-round win streak yet again. TSM, the most they've been able to take consecutively was two.
Yeah, definitely not a sort of good position to come back from. And while TSM, they are looking almost down and out of this at this point, I think that a comeback is almost impossible. And I don't know whether this is off the back of the last map, a sort of detrimental position where they throw one away and it carries over to the next. But this is not looking like the team that we saw in the previous season of ECS that was so good on Cobblestone, the team that sort of this was the map that showed them up as a great team in NA. And while at the moment they're being beaten by one that's seemingly outclassing them at this stage, 11-3 up. FNS will at least get one on the pushing stand, so they have managed to stop him at least from going all the way around the back, but now they have to sort of get into their element. There is four players currently on this B site, nobody defending A, and it seems the rotation will be there. Tarik will burn alive as Relix finishes him off.
Yeah, but look at this right now from TSM. They've already doubled all the way back around. It's a smart play. They're trying to make their way in towards A. Mixwell's going to be the only player for Optic here to try and hold down the fort. Does manage to rotate in fast enough to have some presence on the site. This can delay the push long enough for the rotate to come through. And as the smokes and flashes start to land, you can see Naflight rotating in as well. Mixwell going to find the first, looks for the second as well. He's done so much damage. He's still alive. He's buying so much time for the rotate. Mixwell, he's not showing any sign of giving up just yet. Is finally going to get taken down. Put the Molotov out to delay the plant, and that allows Rush to find the frag. Now it's all on FNS. 1v2, and only 18 points of health.
Yeah, this is a lot to ask of FNS, and well, let's give an opportunity. Hits the dink onto Naf, who's now down to 13 HP. Maybe there's an opportunity, but Rush, well, triple kill in the last. He's looking for the same again. Will break the vent and gives possibly a little bit of a bait, but there is Rush once more. Gets another frag for himself, and we'll just look at the spread as well. Rush currently 12-5. Only two deaths on Naf in a half.
That is.
I didn't notice that before now, and that's ridiculous.
No, that's actually incredible. I didn't realize that. Wow, okay, so, I mean, he's only got 10 frags, but still, that's a 5 KD. That's the best that we've seen today, despite the fact that we saw, what, was it Rain to go 37 and 10? But, you know,
yeah,
KD-wise, he's got a better
Although,
KD
Although, I suppose
right now.
In the first half, it was about even, so, never mind. We'll see if he can continue it on. Either way, it will be Mixwell to have a little bit of a trade early on. A Stan is lost. Semper's going to go aggressive and actually finds one, but traded out very quickly from Tarik as they continue this push onto the A site for now. Of course, with the USP, they do have a good opportunity to actually fight this one back. And again, it will be the spam to try and find some damage.
Yeah, it's a 3-on-3 currently. And I mean, Optic trying to change things up. They take that bomb out of mid and now looking ahead in towards B. Naflight is already here. He's been scouting it out. And well, Tarik actually be the first one in. Hello, too much for Z-Block over here. As Tarik zooms in towards the site, he's doing it sideways. It's 3-on-3, though, like we say currently, with a minute left on the clock. Plenty of time for Optic to change their mind. And well, Relix is going to be the player over towards B to try and hold down the four. You can hear out a couple of footsteps, and they've left Twist as well in towards Connector for the fast rotate between either site.
Yeah, Rush will be the first point of contact with Tarik in. And there we go. Tarik's going to find the first, looking for the second. And while he gets his third kill of the round, it's going to have to be matched by Sick if he wants any chance to come back. And never mind. Tarik goes massive, finishes off the round, three headshots in a row. And that's going to be a 13-3 now. The pistol making things even worse for TSM as they have now lost one of their only lifelines.
Yeah, I mean, it's really not going to be looking good here. Optic picking up the pistol when they're so incredibly far ahead. Now it's 13-3. And providing they win the next two conversion points, they could easily take this to match point within the next couple of rounds.
Yeah, you would almost expect them to at this stage. It's sort of a very difficult position to come back from, especially when you're on the CT side of this map. You really need that economy boost to get yourself rolling, and so far, they are not getting it whatsoever. Of course, we do look towards this CT side now. They're going to try and do their best with these pistols. They've got themselves some CZs, which in the hand of FNS has been pretty deadly so far, has to be said. I have to give props over to him. On the other side of things, though, Optic, they're playing this very, very safe. Four rifles, one SMG onto NAF. He can almost just be the entry fragger for the team, just running around, spraying and praying, and find out any information if there is a stack. Now, there isn't, but that's not something that the T side can know off the cuff. Either way, looking towards this CT side once more. They haven't really done too much in terms of their rotations. They are just pushing sort of sick backwards and forwards to see if he can actually spot anything out. And in terms of where the T seem to be directioning themselves, two players already taking some map presence over towards the A site. As said, NAF is going to be the first point of entry. FNS going to be taken down by Stan, who actually saves NAF.
Yeah, I mean, the idea of them pushing sick backwards and forwards, like you say, it's a pretty gruesome image because of that horrible name. But yeah, it's currently a 3-on-5 as NAF is able to find a frag out on towards long. Now it's going to be a three. Sorry, now there's only two players here out on towards the site to try and hold this up. Rotates coming in the form of Relix. He is making his way up towards Balcony. Now the remaining two players for TSM make their way into the site. But as they get shut down, Rush finds the frag of his own. He'll be looking for the second as well, and he finds it. Relix goes down. It's going to be 14-3. They die holding hands, brothers in arms. And well, now they're one round away from match point.
Yeah, Optic looking to continue this one. And TSM, well, this is a decision to be made. I'm not surprised to see somewhat of a force. It's only really Semphis going for anything here. So they are going to try and fight this all the way back from a 15-3. Now, I like the optimism. I have to say that. They're more optimistic than me. But at least they'll get a buy, I suppose. That's the one little bit of hope, that at least we'll get to see what their buy has to offer. In this round, at least, NAF is just going to be farming a little bit of extra cash, ready for the AWP. Of course, going into the next round, you never know. He may even go for a bonus just for the hell of it to basically show how dominant they have been. And well, he's going to get a 4K to add to the money that he's already got.
Yeah, that's a nice $2,400 kill bonus for him in that round. He's got $7,650 right now. He doesn't care about money. He could drop for his teammates if he wanted to. Not that they're not economically endowed right now as well. He's instead going to be opting to buy up the AWP, as you would expect. Stanislaw opting for the Galil just because it was free, and he's proven to be a big fan of money. It's 15-3 currently, and TSM only able to get a buy on the cards, but with the Mag 7 up on Semphis and very limited utility, it's not going to be looking too ideal for them to be holding on to this one. Mixwell, first man out towards the B site, just bypassing that smoke completely. Oh. Is he going to be ready for Relix? He's pushed up on towards Flat, going to find one. Sick chimes in with a second as well. Tarik and Mixwell both full. And now it's a 3-on-5. Two-man advantage leading the way of TSM very early on. The trades don't come through.
Yeah, it's not been the case so far for the T side. They still have three players left, and we've already spoken about their monetary position. A buy will be coming back. Of course, TSM, they're not really talking about resets at this point. They're talking about losing the game. So I'm not really too worried about economy. Of course, they want to keep as many players as possible to get the best buy possible into this one. Flashbang will go out, and well, you look towards NAF. He's looking to try and find a pick, and if they give it to him, there's still an avenue for them to come back into this round. Passive positions currently being held by TSM. They don't want to go for anything too over-aggressive because the value of it doesn't really sit too well at the moment. Stan actually getting quite far forward. FNS is going to punish, and it doesn't mean that we are back to a 2-5.
Yeah, Rush and NAF, all that remain for Optic here. But if two players could close this one out, I would say be these two. Now gonna be able to find one out of Semphis. That's the counter AWP going down. Of course, you're gonna hit the Mag 7 this time around, but still, it's gonna be a 2-4. Now Rush going very aggressive out towards this site. Gonna push up with as much aggression as he can to help his teammate out, but he's gonna get taken down in the process. Now it's all on NAF 1v4. Well, the money was looking so good on the side of Optic, but heading into this with everyone dying potentially.
He's gonna get caught.
He's gonna be stuck between a rock and a hard place, trying to hide in his smoke. And oh, it's actually worked. They walk straight past him. How did they spot this out? Even he's surprised. Naf, how is this happening? How is this even being allowed
Are
right now?
Are you kidding me?
He knows how cheeky that was. To them, he's just vanished into a cloud of smoke, and he quite literally did.
That's nice. I like it. Just gets away with being a little bit sneaky. And of course, he keeps his ridiculous KD going. 16-3 at the moment in this game. dying less times and they've lost rounds.
I just can't get over that. I can't believe that actually worked.
I thought Relix would have heard him as well. That's the most interesting thing about that. He should have heard the footsteps going back and maybe worked it out at the same time. The form of, well, TSM, at least they get the round on the board. They get themselves a buy. They won't be able to get the AWP out of his hands and into the hands of Semphis, so it's not too beneficial for them overall, and it is going to be a good buy coming back from Optic. Of course, if TSM can win this one, there is the opportunity to send them back to pistols for at least a moment, but there's so many rounds that they have to string together here. This would be a ridiculous sort of comeback to make, and I'm not a believer just yet. I'm a fan of the TSM boys, but this is more than a stretch.
Yeah, but I mean, still, currently they have been able to get at least one round on the CT side, which, you know, it's not too bad. Makes one trying to put a stop to it, does find one out on a twist, but Six there to get the return, puts it back into a 4-on-4. FNS is going to get tagged down low, though, in towards drop, leaving Six to have to pick up the slack. Relic in towards strong, looking to try and go huge, finds one frag, but Tarik is there to get the return. It's going to be a 3-on-3, and the push coming out solely towards long. Rotate coming in from A. It's going to be a little bit later. There's Nath puts the hurt on FNS. It's going to be that much more weak in this B site. Both players fall. Now it's all Semphis. And, well, he is quite late on the old rotate.
Yeah, it's going to be down to the in-game leader himself to try and bring this one home. Definitely one of the most experienced in the server at the moment, but it's still a lot to ask. Nath is going to be spotting this one, looking to keep his ridiculous KD intact. And, well, Need will at least get a little bit of HP down. In fact, only two. And there goes Nath finishing things off. What a ridiculous game from the AWP, ending 19-3. I think we saw probably the most kills I've seen in quite a while earlier, and now the least deaths I think I've ever seen in this match. So what an absolutely ridiculous performance coming out across the board. To highlight individuals becomes quite difficult, really, because everybody really had an absolutely crazy game, and that was just a trouncing. TSM didn't even really get going at all.
Yeah, no, I mean, I have to agree. Optic, we said coming up to it was their map choice. It was what they wanted to do. They looked strong enough on Dust. And as we headed into Cobble, it was fairly assured their future. It was immediately clear the second they took it, what, the first? It was like 7-0 or something ridiculous. And yeah, then finally TSM got around on the board. But you could just tell they were leaps and bounds ahead of their opponents into that one. And Nath, I mean, he had 3 deaths or something ridiculous towards the end. So, yeah, no, what an incredible display of skill from everyone. We're going to be taking a
short break,
and we'll be back after that.